podcast is sponsored by MrExcel. Learn Excel from MrExcel podcast, episode 1392, format change cells. Well, hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I got a note from Tom. Tom says he's been watching since episode 103. That's a long time. He just got a large amount of data came down from an inventory or something like that. He needs to go through and quickly format some cells. Now, you know, my first thought here is he was looking for error cells. You know, if you apply a format to a cell, all right, and you're not doing anything else to the data, the F4 key is just an amazing trick. You can just go select a cell, press F4, and it repeats the last command. Whatever the last command you did, it will repeat that. So if you just need to mark a whole bunch of cells, well, mark one, and then you can use F4. But let's say that you did two things. So let's say you applied a background color and also a foreground color. Now when you press F4, unfortunately, both of those things aren't going to get repeated, just the last one. So that's where the format painter can be an amazing trick. The little paintbrush up here, double click. All right, and now anytime I touch a cell, I'm applying that format. So I talked to Tom, but really what Tom is doing is when he spots an error where the data on the server is wrong and edits that cell, he wants to automatically change the color of that cell. And to do that, that's going to be a little bit of VBA. Let me press escape to get out of format painter mode here. And then we'll do Alt F11 to switch over. And I'm going to find the worksheet that I'm in. So I'm in book one, I'm on sheet one. I want to double click there. And now we have two drop downs at the top. From the leftmost drop down, I'm going to choose worksheet and then change. Every time that we change a cell, this little macro will get run. It gives us a variable called target. Target is the range that we just changed. So right in here, we can just say target dot font dot color. I'm going to use color index equals 4. If you're, this will work in Excel 2003, by the way. If you're in Excel 2007, you can just do dot color equals 255. 255 being red. And I'm not actually sure. I think 4 is red, but we'll find out here real quick. When we go back to Excel, so I just come here and I change the number, 1,000 in, and see, green, that's kind of ugly. It must be, I don't know, is it 3, is it 2? I would have thought I would have tested this before I turned on the recorder, wouldn't you have? Yeah, 1,000, yeah, there we go. So, dot color index equals 3, or if you're in Excel 2007 and newer, we can just do dot color equals 255. That'll get a nice red. If you want some other color, turn on the macro recorder and figure out what the settings are there. So this kind of just runs quietly in the background, change a cell, and it will instantly note that. Not as cool as Outlook, of course. When you start to change things in Outlook, it automatically changes to blue, or you know, so requires a macro. Still a cool way to go. I want to thank Tom for hanging around since episode 103, and thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another netcast. Mr. Excel.